we have to give Cory Sandhagen his due, because DC, I've been very high on Cory Sandhagen, and some people said I was a little too high on him, and then he stumbles against Aljo, and then in a weird way gets a bigger fight in his next fight. His bounce back fight is a higher profile fight. It's a main event against the former champion in WSOF, former title contender Marlon Moraes, and what does he do? He knocks him out with an incredible spinning heel kick. I mean, just an amazing performance. And it makes me think once again that Cory Sandhagen is going to fight for the belt one day. That was just an amazing win. He started off calm, cool, and collected. And you know about this, right? It actually made me think about you a little bit. You come off the biggest loss of your career, and then you have to fight. The next fight is bigger than that one. Reminds me of you versus Jones and you versus Rumble, right? Reminds me of you versus Jones, you versus Volkan. And he stepped up to the plate just like you did. Very impressive stuff.
Well, it's a matter of how do you recover after something so devastating, right? There's a saying, I don't know it exactly, like the measure of a man is not how he behaves in the comfortable times, but how he handles the times where it's, you know exactly what I'm talking about, right?
Close enough.
It's something of that saying, you know, like,
right. Yeah,
but sure. How do you measure Cory Sandhagen after you saw him last weekend? Because you went in a fight with Aljo that at the time people were saying, this should be for the vacant title. This should be the title fight, right? Cory Sandhagen, this guy, Aljo, this should be. And they decided to go Piotr Jan and Jose Aldo. But he got beat in that big moment, went back and had to face down what many people think is the most dangerous fighter in that division, right? Marlon Moraes is scary. He beat on Henry Cejudo at the beginning of this fight. He has looked like a world beater. He beat Aljo, knocked out Aljo, right? How do you bounce back? And what he did on Saturday night was truly amazing. For him to stand in there and be so comfortable to throw that attack and land it in the way that he did. When you talk about making a statement and reintroducing yourself to the highest part of the highest level of your division, that's what Sandhagen did. It does not feel like the loss now did anything to hurt his stock in the bantamweight division now after that performance.
What I love about Sandhagen is, like, he doesn't look like your typical fighter, right? Like, afterwards, a reporter asked him why he came out to Biggie's Give Me the Loot. And he's like, yeah, I look like a pale white guy from Colorado, but I'm gangsta too. I was like, yeah, you know, Cory Sandhagen, he's the man. He hates paper towels. I don't know if you know this about him. He's very environmentally friendly. He's really into the environment. So, like, to me, it was just like he was just attacking Marlon Moraes, like he's a guy who uses too many paper towels. You know what I mean?
That's all cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's all cool. You know that he doesn't like paper towels and that he's a gangster. But I really just care about him being able to fight. And I care about the fact that he had a great performance on Saturday. You know, I get all that's you, right? Like, you bring all these things together. But the reality is, I don't really care how much he likes paper towels. I just like that he can really get after it and that he had that type of performance. And honestly puts himself in line now for another big spot. And on Saturday night, he said something like, I'm not, you know, I can get a title shot, right? He feels like he's right back in the title picture. And after losing the fight before, most times you'd laugh it off, right? Like, this guy, whatever, he's just talking. But when you beat the number one contender in the division in the way that he did, you really got to start paying attention to it and start really saying, Sandhagen isn't 2-3 fights away now from earning the title fight. If he can win one more, or if he's willing to play the backup for Aljamain versus Piotr Jan, I'd put him there.
Well, you know who was the biggest winner on Saturday?
Oh,
Aljamain Sterling, right? He was the biggest winner by far.
No. Aljamain Sterling wasn't the biggest winner. It was good for Aljo, right? That Cory Sandhagen won. The brother that did that spinning back kick thing was the one. That dude. I know I'm getting ahead of myself, but when you say who's the biggest winner of the night, yeah, sure. Aljo, that was great for Aljo, but nobody won bigger than the brother with that spinning kick, that matrix stuff that he did.
Okay, fair enough. I just mean from that fight, that result.
Okay, from that fight, yes.
Joaquin Buckley, a.k.a.
Well, let's not act like Cory Sandhagen. Aljo, because he dominated in that way, yes, big moment for him. Well, and really feels like it secures a title fight for him, right?
That's why he was the big winner, because A, number one, the win over Sandhagen looks better in hindsight. And B, there was talk of Marlon fighting Jan last week. Even Jan himself put it out, as crazy as it was. So I feel like Aljo's the big winner because it secures it. So I'm happy for him. But what about what Cory Sandhagen said after the fight? He threw out two names, Frankie Edgar, fine. But another one who we haven't heard of in a long time, TJ Dillashaw. I love this idea. TJ coming back against Cory Sandhagen. Now, people need to know, TJ Dillashaw's suspension is up in mid-January. He's free to fight come, I think, January 20th of 2021. So he's up in like 3 months, essentially.
Yeah, it's getting close.
I love that fight.
So I read somewhere that TJ Dillashaw may be coming back at 125. He might be coming back as a flyweight.
There's no chance he's coming back at 125.
I read that somewhere. I read that on the internet somewhere that he was coming back as a flyweight. And, I mean,
what got him in this mess?
Hey, listen, sometimes people learn. It's a little harder for people to learn their lessons. You know, we want to keep trying to correct it. But Sandhagen versus Dillashaw, that's a great fight. It's a great fight for both, though, right? Because if TJ beats Cory Sandhagen, he puts himself right back in line. And if Cory Sandhagen beats him, it's that big, shiny name. We talk about this all the time, right? We talk about it with Neil Magny, with Leon Edwards all the time. You need that big, shiny name on your resume that makes everybody take notice. And I believe that if Cory Sandhagen can get a win over a former champion, TJ Dillashaw, that's exactly what he needs.
And conversely, if Dillashaw beats him, now he's right back in that picture.
Right back where he was. But, I mean, going for 2 years and that's the type of fight you come back into as TJ Dillashaw, I mean, wow, that's a big moment.
Yeah, maybe it is a little tough. I mean, TJ versus Edgar, 135 is very fun. I know now for sure it should be Sterling versus Jan, maybe even on December 12th. Then we'll get to that card in a little bit, which, of course, lost its main event last week.
Thank you for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.